Dear fellow coders, welcome to One Little Coder. Training your own model is something a lot of people are scared of, especially in NLP. A lot of us are happy with the pre-trained models that are already available on Hugging Face. We don't want to fine-tune it, we don't want to custom train it. We are just happy downloading the model and then using it for our own purpose. But here you have a simple package. It's even called Simple T5. The objective of this library is to enable you quickly train your own T5 models rather than downloading a pre-trained model. And using it out of box, you can actually custom train your model so that the output accuracy that you get is more efficient for the kind of task that you are trying to do. In this case, we are going to focus on summarization. So T5 library is built on top of PyTorch and PyTorch Lightning and Transformers, which is from Hugging Face, to let you quickly train your own T5 models. So this can be used for a lot of tasks like summarization, question and answer generation, translation, text generation, and a lot of other things. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to install the library, how to get started, and then we are going to also see a quick example. Before we move on, thanks to Shivanand Roy, who's the author of this library and also made it open source. Shivanand has also put together a collab notebook, which is served as the primary code base for my code that I'm going to show you. Also, there is a very excellent article that has been written. I will link these two in the YouTube description. You can check it out. So in this next, what we are going to do now is we're going to pick a Kaggle data set and we are going to exactly do an abstractive summarization with T5, but instead of training it from scratch, we're going to use simple T5 and then make it easier for us to do training. First, we need a dataset. The dataset that we're going to use is called new summary dataset. So this has a lot of columns, but the column that we are interested in is headlines and text. So the headlines is more like our summarized text, and then the text is like the actual text based on which the headlines is summarized. So that's how we are going to use it. So let's get started. First thing you have to do is go to this dataset. And click new notebook. Once you click new notebook, it's going to create a new Python notebook for you. And after you get the Python notebook, go to the settings and make sure that you select GPU accelerator, because we are going to use GPU in this code and tutorial. So new notebook, go to the dataset, which also I'll link in the YouTube description. Go to the dataset, click new notebook. Once you get the notebook, go to settings, accelerator, GPU. Once that is done, so import the necessary libraries. In our case, we need we actually don't need NumPy. Pandas is for for CSV, and then we are going to train the model, so we want to keep some validation data set. So we're going to import train test split. Also, we are going to then later on import simple T5. So basically, to start with this one, so the CSV that we are interested in is new summary. But before we read that CSV, let's quickly install simple T5. Simple T5 is the library name. You can actually do quiet, but I've just installed without quiet. So it installs all the required libraries. So again, another important information is if you want to install a library, you might want to activate or enable internet on your Kaggle notebook so that you can install your custom library. Once that is done, now we have to import the data frame. So to import the data frame, it's quite simple. You can go to the Kaggle data and then you can go inside the new summary and then copy the path, and then you can paste that path here. So pd.read_csv and then the file path, and this data has some text that is not simply easily available to be read from UTF-8 encoding. So we are using Latin-1 encoding, and then the columns that we want is headlines and text. Read this. Once you read that, you can actually quickly see how it looks. Df head. You can see you have a title column name called headlines. You have a column name called text. So after that, it is time for us to prepare this data that is in such a way that T5 models could use for training. So T5 models are models that will create sequence, which means like you need to set of text. One is your source text, the second is your target text. So basically what you're going to do is you're going to tell T5 what kind of task you want to do and what is your source text and what is your target text. So what is our source text? Our source text is wherever we have got text. So the big chunk of text is our source text, and then we are telling T5 that what are the headlines, that is my target text. So now at this point we are renaming the columns, and then we are going to have source text and target text. So now we have source text and target text. So once we have these two, now we have to define what kind of NLP task that we are trying to do. So like I said before, we are focusing on summarization. Summarization is the task that we are interested in, especially because we are interested in abstractive summarization. Most of the out-of-box solutions give you extractive summarization. So abstractive summarization may not be accurate in every case, and that is why we are interested in, you know, training our own model, so that whenever we want to summarize the news article, it will be highly accurate. Okay, so now we are going to say summarize is the task. So for that, we are going to prefix. We are going to add a prefix saying summarize before our source text. So if you look at our source text, you would see summarize at the start of every single sentence row. Now that our input data is ready for us to proceed further, let's do a good thing, which is to split our training and test data in case if you want to use the test data to validate later on. So we are splitting the training and test 70-30, and then we are going to use our training data to further proceed. So now that our data is ready, prepared for us to train a model, so that data processing, preparing our input data set, reading our input data set, so all these are done. So now what we are going to do is we are going to enter into the simple T5 territory. So what simple T5 actually does is, simple T5 lets you train your own model in three-step process. First, you, like, of course, after you import the model, which is from simple T5, you import simple T5. Remember the case here, simple S uppercase, T uppercase. After you import that, you instantiate your simple T5 class. So simple T5, and that has been assigned to the object model, and from model you're going to download the pre-trained model. So this model, I think most likely it is going to get downloaded from Hugging Face Model Hub. So now after this is done, at this point you can train your own model. So what are you going to use to train your own model? So first of all, you need a training data frame, which is here, and then you need an evaluation data frame, which is our test DF, and a couple of other parameters that you want to give, like maximum token length, target token length, like batch size, number of epochs you want based on the time you have got, and of course if you have got GPU, please make sure that you use GPU. So once this is done, you can actually see that this process would take on. So I'm not going to run this cell, primarily because I don't want you to look at my screen for 10 minutes, another 10 minutes, and then see what is happening with the model training process. So when I click this thing, model training is going to start, and then it's going to go for 4 epochs. At the end of this process, it's going to create a folder called outputs, and then it's going to save models at a different checkpoint or different training loss values. How do we get to know that? So this is a very simple Unix command for us to know what is inside the outputs folder. Once you click this, you will get to know there are different models available inside output folder. So outputs folder. So outputs exist inside output. Like in Kaggle's case, if you're actually doing it on your local machine, so you would probably have only one folder, not like a folder and subfolder, called outputs. So here, because we have outputs, you can see that there are different models stored. So let's pick the model with the least loss. So I'm going to pick this model. So when you pick this model, now the next step is model inference. You're going to say load the model. So let's load the model from this folder. So which means you need to give the path, which is outputs slash and the model name. And then you still say, like, I want to use GPU for inferencing. So now let's run it. It's going to take a couple of seconds, and then it is ran. So it is ran successfully at this point. So now we have successfully did data pre-processing, trained the model, loaded the model for our inferencing. So a point to notice, if you're going to ever use this code snippet for creating a web application, let's say using Streamlit or Flask or Django or like anything, anywhere you, if you're going to use for inference, you don't have to do anything that we did above. If you're going to just do inference, all you need is just this model. You just need this model file, or I should say like that folder, and you can simply do model inferencing without any of the previous step. So all the previous step is required if you're going to do your own training. That's the whole point of this video. But if you're going to do training, you are not going to do training every single time. So you do training once, then you're going to use it for inference. Maybe like you create an API out of it, or you're going to put it inside a web app. So whatever the purpose is, you don't have to train again and again until you have a model refresh cycle. So that's a small information. So once the model is successfully loaded into our workspace, or I should say session, now the next objective is to summarize the model. And as we have seen before, so we need a source text, and then it's going to give us the target text, which is the summarized text. And source text must start with like a prefix with summarize, which is to indicate the T5 model that the NLP task that we are trying to do here is summarization. So now I'm going to pick an article, just like an article that was recently came, like which is in this case Twitter India interim grievance officer quits. This article is from I think The Hindu. So I have picked that article, and then I have given that article content, like part of that content here, and then it has a lot of text. Now when I use that to predict, you can see basically it gives one line that says Twitter's resident grievance officer for India steps down, which is a very, very good summarization. So like even if you see the first line, Twitter's interim resident grievance officer for India has stepped down. So it has, it has done a summarization. You can run it again and see if it changes. So the next article that I tried is, it's about the Delta Plus variant and some news from WHO. And if I do the same thing, like I give summarize and then the text, and if I summarization, it says wearing masks, face masks is essential to fight Delta Plus. That's what WHO says. Like let's say wearing face masks. So you can see that it is not doing extractive summarization, because wearing face mask are essential is one part of the sentence that you can see is available here. But then you can also see to fight Delta Plus. So that is not immediately available, but you can see how it has summarized. So let's try to pick one more article from our news, and then we can probably see. Okay, Covishield excluded from, okay. So let's pick this article and then take the text. So let me just copy and paste this for now. Okay, where is this article? So I'm going to copy this article. I think my only problem with this article would be a lot of, okay, and let me also copy this. Okay, let's just copy this and then run it. When we run it, it says Covishield infected travelers not eligible for EU's green pass. So even like if you see the news article says Covishield excluded from new EU COVID green pass. So this model actually does a very good job in creating the title for the article that you have given for summarization. So that was a whole objective of this thing. So you give a bunch of lines of text and it does abstractive summarization, and it gives you something that sounds similar to a news headline. And we have successfully managed to take an existing model and train it for our own purpose with our own training data, and then get an output model which we can use for summarization, like inference, anytime you want. So this is how a simple T5 makes it simpler for you to train your own model. So this example that we have seen is for summarization, but you can use it for any NLP task, of course. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section. Otherwise, this Kaggle notebook, the article that the developer, who is Shivanand Roy, has written, and also the GitHub repository would be linked in the YouTube description. Please give a shout out to the developer and also make sure that you star their repository. And if you think that this video was helpful to you, please subscribe to the channel, share the video with your friends, then share NLP learning. I hope this video was helpful to you, and until next video, stay safe.